Hi everyone, welcome back. In today's video, I am going to show you how to set up a dual boot system with kalilinux and Windows 11. If you want to try out kalilinux without deleting Windows, you can install both operating systems on the same machine. And whenever needed, you can choose to use either one. So let's get started. First, we need to download the kalilinux ISO file. So open your browser and type kalilinux in the search bar. From the search result, click on the official website, which is kali.org. Once you are on the website, you will see it's described as the most advanced penetration testing distribution. Yep, that's exactly what you need. Now click on the download button at the top menu. Here you will see two options, installer images and virtual machine. Since we are going to install it on our physical system, so click on installer image. Then scroll down a bit and you will see download links for different architecture. So choose the kalilinux 64-bit installer, which is perfect for most modern PC. Click the little download arrow icon and the ISO will begin downloading. It's around 4.1 GB, so depending on your internet speed, this might take a while. So let it download in the background. While kalilinux is downloading, we need a tool to create a bootable USB drive. We will use Rufus for this. So open another tab and search for Rufus download. Click on the official site, which is usually rufus.ie. Then scroll down a bit and under download, look for the latest version. At the time of recording, it's Rufus 4.9. So click on the .exe file link and it will download instantly. So it's a very small file. Once both files are downloaded, kalilinux ISO and Rufus, you are ready for the next step. Now open the Rufus application. There's no need to install it, it's a portable tool. So it opens directly. Since I have already used it before, I am just searching it here and opening it for my recent file. Next, plug in your USB drive and make sure it's at least 8 GB and has no important data, as this process will erase everything. Once plugged in, Rufus will automatically detect your USB. And in my case, you can see I'm using a 32 GB drive. Now click the select button next to boot selection. Then navigate to your kalilinux ISO file and select it. You can leave the other settings as they are. And now click start. Rufus will now create the bootable kalilinux USB. This might take a minute to complete. Once it says ready in green, click on close. And congrats, you now have your kalilinux bootable USB ready. Before we install kalilinux, we need to create the free space on your hard drive. So here you can see I have only two drives in my PC, so that I don't have any free space now. That's why I am going to make another partition in C drive. Okay, so for that, right click on the start button and select disk management. Find your Windows drive, that is usually C drive, and now you need to right click on it and select shrink volume. Now you need to wait for a second here. Once open, you need to decide how much space you want to allocate for the kalilinux. At least 20 to 30 GB is recommended, okay. But I am going to enter the amount here is 102400 in MB and click on shrink. It will going to create 100 GB space. You will now see an unallocated space on your drive where kalilinux will be installed. Okay, once the partition is created, after that you need to restart your computer and enter into the BIOS or UEFI setting. Usually by pressing a key like F2, F10 or Del during boot, you can enter to the BIOS or UEFI settings. But in my case, it is delete key. So once in the BIOS UEFI settings, you need to navigate to the boot menu and first you need to search for secure boot options. From here, you need to disable the secure boot options. This is necessary because secure boot might block the kalilinux bootloader from running. Okay. So once you disable this, after that you need to search for boot option priorities and set your USB drive as a primary boot device. That means boot options 1. Okay. Then after that, click on save and exit. Then double click on Save and Exit Setup and click on Yes to save the changes we made. Your computer should now boot from the USB drive. Okay. Wait for a few seconds and the kalilinux installation screen will appear. Now you need to choose Graphical Install from the boot menu list. And now follow the on-screen prompts. So first you need to select your language, that is English, and then click on Continue. And here you need to select your location. So in my case, India. And after that, you need to click on Continue. And here you need to configure the keyboard layout. So you can select American English. Your computer will now attempt to configure the network settings automatically. In the next step, it is asking for host name. So I'm going to name it Kali and then press the Continue button. Next, it will ask for a full name for the new user under the setup user and password section. Okay. So I'm going to name it Tech Info Card and then press the Continue button. Next, type username for your account. So I have to keep it same and click on Continue. Now here you need to create a password for the new user and re-enter the password again to verify it. Okay. Now you will be asked to select a partition method. So choose manual and click Continue. From the partition menu, select the free space that we created earlier. 100 GB of size, okay. So be careful here to avoid selecting your existing Windows partition, okay. Once selected, click Continue. In the partition disk menu, select automatically partition the free space and then click on Confirm. Choose all files in one partition. Recommended for new user and click Continue. Then you can click Finish Partition and write changes to disk. Then confirm by selecting Yes to write the changes to the disk. Partitioning and formatting will now begin. This may take some time, so please be patient. In the next screen, in case you want to add some additional software, you can select it on the following screen like GNOME, KDE, Plasma, and then click on Continue to proceed. The installation process can take some time. After that, select any of the following for default display manager, okay, and followed by Continue. Now wait for another few minutes to complete the setup. So grab a cup of coffee, relax, and let the installer do its job. Once the installation is complete, you will see the Finish the installation message. The system will then ask you to remove the installation media and reboot. So unplug the pen drive and click Continue to reboot the system. After rebooting, the kalilinux login screen will appear. Enter the password you created earlier and press Enter. Congratulations, you now have kalilinux running on your Windows 11 machine with dual boot. Now let's check if you can boot back into the Windows. To do this, click on the power button at the top right corner of the screen and select power off, then click restart. On startup, the bootloader menu will again appear. And from the list, here you need to select Windows bootloader to boot into Windows. And here you go. You are now back in Windows. You can now choose to boot into either Windows 11 or kalilinux whenever required. And that's it. You have successfully set up a dual boot system with kalilinux and Windows 11. Now every time you start your PC, you will have the choice to use either kalilinux or Windows. If this video helped you, please give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and don't forget to comment below if you face any issue. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.